The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 8th chapter, text 12 through 14, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in October of 1966 in New York.
Kludarani Sangyamya Muno Lidi Niruddhacha Mudna Dhaya Atmana Pranam Astita Yogadharanam. We have been discussing about the transmigration of the soul. There are different kinds of transcendentalists who are called yogi. Jnana yogi, Dhyana yogi, and Bhakta yogi. All the yogis, they are eligible to be transferred to the spiritual world. The yoga system is meant for linking our connection. We are eternally connected with the Supreme Lord. Somehow or other, we are now in material contamination. The process is that we have to go back again. So that linking process is called yoga. Yoga, the actual translation of the word yoga means plus. Plus. Just the opposite, a minus. Now at the present moment, we are minus God and minus Supreme. So when we make ourselves plus connected, then our human form of life is perfect. So, at the time of death, we have to finish that perfection. So long we are alive, we have to practice how to approach that point of perfection. And at the time of death, when we give up this material body, that perfection has to be realized. So, for the last 3 days, we have been discussing prayanakale manasa chalino. Prayanakale means at the time of death. Just like the students, they prepare 2 years, 3 years, 5 years in their college education. And the final test is their examination. And if they pass in the examination, they get the degree. Similarly, in our living condition, if we prepare for the examination at the time of death and we pass the examination, then we are transferred to the spiritual world. So, prayanakale, the whole thing is examined at the time of death. Just the other day, I recited one Bengali proverb. This is a very common saying in Bengal. They say, bhajan karo, pujan karo, motte janle hoy. Or whatever you do for perfection, at the time of your death, it will be tested. At the time of your death. So, Bhagavad Gita is describing what should we do at the point of our death, when we are giving up this body, this present body. So for the yogis, dhyana yogis, this prescription is recited here. The sarvadharani sangyamma mana ridhi niruddhacha. Sarvadharani means, this system is called pratyahara. In the technical language of yogic system, it is called pratyahara. Pratyahara means, just the opposite. Now, the senses, my eyes are engaged in seeing the worldly beauty. Now, I have to retract from enjoying that beauty and I have to see inside the beauty. This is called pratyahara. Similarly, I have to hear the Omkar sound from within. So all the senses have to be stopped in their external activities, that is the perfection of yoga, and concentrate the mind on Vishnu Murti, Mano Ridhi. The mind is very agitating, so it has to be fixed on the heart. Mano Ridhi, Niruddha. Niruddha means just arresting the mind within the heart. Mudra, mudra dhyayatmana pranam asita yogadharana. And in this way, when we transfer the air life on the top of our head, that is the perfection of yoga. And a perfect yogi, then he fixes up where he shall go. There are innumerable planets, and beyond the planets, there are spiritual worlds. So yogis, they have got information. How they have got information? From the scriptures, from Vedic literature, they have got. Just like before I came to your country, I got the description of your country from the books. Similarly, we can have all the description of higher planets and the spiritual world, they are mentioned there. The yogi knows everything, and he can transfer his self to any planet he likes. He does not require the help of any Sputnik. The Sputnik, they are trying for so many years, and they will go on trying for 100 or 1,000 years more. They will never reach any planet. Be rest assured. This is not the process. This is not the process to reach another planet. Maybe by scientific process one man or two men can reach, but that is not the general process. The general process is, if you want to transfer yourself any better planet, then you have to practice this yoga system or jnana system, not bhakti system. Bhakti system is not meant for any material planet. That will be explained later on. Those who are in devotional service of Krishna, of the Supreme Lord, they are not interested in any planets of this material world. Why? Because they know in any planet you can raise yourself, you can elevate yourself, you can go there. But the four principles of material existence are there. What is that? Birth, death, disease and old age. Any planet you go. Your duration of life may be very, very longer than this earth, but death is there. Death is there. But those who are in Krishna consciousness, or those who are otherwise, those who are not interested in this material life. Material life means birth, death, disease and old age. And spiritual life means relief from this bothering. No more birth, no more death, no more ignorance, no more misery. So those who are intelligent, they do not try to elevate in any planet of this material world. There are higher planets you have got. You get a long duration of life. That's like we are trying to reach the moon planet. And actually, if we get entrance into the moon planet, it is very difficult to get entrance. But even if you get entrance, then the period of life will be, enhanced. Of course, not in this body. Perhaps if you enter with this body, in instant death is sure. But if you enter into higher planets by this yoga system, then you get the suitable body of that planet. Every planet has got a suitable body. You cannot enter, and just like you cannot live in the water with this body. You can make an experiment. You can live there and within, not as a 24 hours or 15 hours or 16 hours, that's all. But the fish, the aquatic animals, they have got particular bodies. They are living whole life. Similarly, if you take out the fishes from water and put them on the land, they will instantly die. As you see, even in this planet, that you have got to make your different kinds of body to live in a particular place. So similarly, if you want to enter into another planet, you have to prepare yourself to get that particular type of body. So if anyone enters into the moon planet by this yogic process, he transfers his soul, transmigrates into the moon planet, he'll get long duration of life. In higher planets, our 6 months equal to their 1 day. And such 1 month, 1 year, for 10,000 of years they live. That is the description we get. So we get very long duration of life, undoubtedly. But there is death. There is death. After 10,000 years or 20,000 years or millions of years, that doesn't matter. It is all counted, and death is there. But you are not subjected to the death. That is the beginning of Bhagavad Gita. Na hannati hannamane sarire. You are spirit soul. You are eternal. Keep the watch here. You are eternal. Why should you subject yourself to this death and birth? This is intelligence. This is intelligence. So, Krishna ke bhaje sevara chaku. Those who are persons in Krishna consciousness, they are very intelligent. They are not interested to get promotion in any planet where there is death. Never mind the long duration of life there is. They want, just like God, Sachidananda Vigraha, Isara Paramakrishna, Sachidananda Vigraha. The God's body is Sachit, Sachit, Ananda. Sat means eternal, and Chit means full of knowledge, and Ananda means full of pleasure. We have got our pamphlet, most of you might have seen, Krishna, the reservoir of all pleasure. Similarly, if we transfer our body, ourself, leaving this body, to the spiritual world, in the Krishna planet or any other spiritual planet, then we get the similar body, Sat-Chit Ananda, eternal, full of knowledge and full of bliss. So those who are trying to be in Krishna consciousness, their aim of life is different than those who are trying to promote themselves in any of the better planets in this material world. See here, Lord Krishna says that mudna dhaya atmana pranam asita yoga dharanam. This is called the perfection of yoga. If you can transfer yourself, you are very minute particle within this body that you cannot see. But my position is, this is external. This is external. So that is sustaining in the pranavayu. And the yoga system, the satachakra system is to get the soul from down to the tip of the topmost part of the head. This practice goes on while we are living. And the perfection is that when it can place my myself on the top of the head and by fracture of this top muscle we can transfer into the higher planet as we like. That is the perfection. A yogi can transfer in either of these planets, wherever he likes. So, if you like, just like you are inquisitive to see what is the moon planet, so if the yogi likes, oh, let me see what is the moon planet, then I shall transfer myself to higher planets. Just like travelers, they come to New York, then go to California, then go to Canada. Similarly, you can transfer yourself in so many planets by this yoga system. But anywhere you go, the same system, Gita system and custom system, they are... So Krishna conscious persons, they are not interested in these temporary planets. Maybe for a long duration, but they are not interested. So for the yogi, the process is how to give up this body. Om ittika aksharang brahma bharan mamam ismaran japrayati tajana dehaṁ sajati paramangati. At the time of death, point of death, Om, and you can pronounce Om, Omkar. Omkar is the concise form of transcendental vibration. Omkar. So Om iteka aksarang brahma baharan. If you can vibrate this sound, Omkar. At the same time, Mahamanusmaran. Plus, he remembers Krishna and Vishnu. The whole yoga system is to concentrate his mind to Vishnu. But the impersonalists, they imagine that this is the form of Vishnu or the Lord. But those who are personalists, they do not imagine, they see actual form of the Supreme Lord. Anyway, either you concentrate your mind like imagination, or you see actually, you have to concentrate your mind in the Vishnu form, your mom. Mom means unto the Supreme Lord, Vishnu. Japrayasi, anyone who leaves this body, tajan deha, after quitting this body, sajati paramangati, he enters into the spiritual kingdom. Unless he desires, those who actually yogi, they do not desire to enter any other planet. Because they also know that the temporary planets, temporary life, they are not interested. That is the intelligence. Antavattu phalam tesam tad bhavati alpamedasa. Those who are satisfied with temporary happiness, temporary life, temporary facilities, they are not intelligent, according to Bhagavad Gita. They are not intelligent. Antavattu phalam tesa tad bhavati alpamedasa. One whose brain substance is very small, they are interested in these temporary things. That is the version of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Because I am permanent, I am eternal. Why shall I be interested in non-permanent things? That is the intelligence. Who wants non-permanent, existence? Nobody wants. Suppose you are living in an apartment, and the landlord asks you to vacate, or somehow or other you have to vacate, you are sorry. But you will not be sorry if you go to a better apartment. So this is our nature, that wherever we live, because we are permanent, so we want permanent residence. That is our inclination. So don't wish to die. Why? Because we are permanent. death is. That's why we don't want to be diseased. These are all artificial, external things. Disease, death, birth, miseries, they are not our, they are external things. Just like sometimes you are attacked with fever. You are not meant for suffering from fever, but sometimes it comes upon you. So you have to take precaution, have to get out of it. So similarly, these four kinds of external afflictions, birth, death, disease and old age, they are due to this material body. And if we can get out of this material body, then we can get out of these implications. So for the yogi, those are impersonalists, for them this process is recommended. What is that? Om Ittika Kshanam Brahma Bharan, just vibrating this transcendental sound, Om, I'll leave this body. Then Japrayati, anyone who is able, what is the word? That's right. Anyone who is able to quit this material body in this circumstance, simply by uttering this transcendental sound, Oh, with full consciousness of the Supreme Lord, then he is sure to be transferred, to transmigrate in the spiritual world. But those who are not personalists, they cannot enter into the spiritual planet. They remain outside. Just like the sun sign and the sun disk. The sun sign is not different from the sun sign, sun disk. But still, the sun sign is not the sun disk. Similarly, those who are transferred in the spiritual world, they remain in the effulgence of the Supreme Lord, which is called Brahma Jyoti. Brahma Jyoti. So, those who are not personalists, they are placed into that Brahma Jyoti as one of the minute particles. So, we are minute particles, spiritual spark. And Brahma Jyoti is full of spiritual spark. So, you become one of the spiritual spark, that is means you merge into the spiritual existence. Although you keep your individuality, constitutionally, but because you don't want any personal form, therefore you are held there. Held there in the impersonal Brahma Jyoti. Just like the sun sign are small molecules, shining molecules, those who are scientists, they know that similarly we are also a small molecular atomic, less than atom. 1/10,000 portion of the tip of the hair our position is. So that small part remains in the Brahma Jyoti as it mixed up, homogeneous. Although, so the difficulty is, as living entity, we want enjoyment. Because I am not only simply existence, I have got bliss, sat-chit-ananda. I am composed of three spiritual existence. I am eternal, and I am full of knowledge, and I am full of bliss. So, those who enter into that impersonal effulgence of the Supreme Lord, they can remain eternally and with full knowledge that I am now mixed up, I am now homogeneous with the Brahma. But they cannot have that eternal bliss, because that part is wanting. So, the difficulty is that when he feels, just like you, if you are confined in a room alone, you may go on, you may engage yourself in reading some particular book or in some thought. But still, you cannot remain alone for all the years and all the time. That is not possible. He'll find some association. He'll find some association, recreation. That is our nature. Similarly, if we merge into the impersonal effulgence of the Supreme Lord, then there is chance of falling down again in this material world. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Jannair vindakha vimukta manina tayyasta bhavat avishuddha buddhaya arujya kritchena parampadam tata patanti adha. And now, this is a smadanga. Just like the Sputniks, man, the aeronautics, they go higher and higher, 25,000 or 30,000 or 100,000 miles away. But if they cannot take rest in some planet, they will fall down. At once fall down again. So the rest is required. In the impersonal form, the rest is uncertain. Uncertain. Therefore, the Bhagavad says, the arujya kritchena param padam tata. Even after so much endeavor, if he gets into the spiritual world and remains in that impersonal form, the risk is that patanti adha, he comes down again into this material world. Why? Anadita jusmadangaya, because he has neglected to serve in love and devotion the Supreme Lord. So long we are here, we have to practice to love Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Then we can enter. This is the training. And if I am not trained up in that way, then by impersonal endeavor we can enter into the spiritual kingdom, but there is risk of falling down again. Because that alone, that loneliness will create some disturbance and will try to have association. And because he has no association with the Supreme Lord, he will have to come back into this material world and associate with this material world. So better, so we should know the nature of our constitutional position. Our constitutional position is that we want eternity. We want complete knowledge. And we want pleasure also. So, if you are kept alone, you cannot have pleasure. Then you feel uncomfortable. And for want of pleasure, you'll accept any kind of pleasure, all like material pleasure. That's all. That is the reason. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness, will have full pleasure. Full pleasure. The same pleasure, not the same pleasure, just like here the highest pleasure of this world is sex life. That is also perverted. So disease. So even in the spiritual world, there is sex pleasure in Krishna. But we should not think that this is something like this, no. But Jamadasajata, unless that sex life is there, it cannot be reflected here. It is simply perverted reflection. The actual life is there. In Krishna. Krishna is full of pleasure. The best thing is to train ourselves. Train ourselves in this Krishna consciousness. And then it will be possible in this life, at the time of death, to transfer ourselves into the spiritual world and enter into the Krishna law on the Krishna planet and enjoy with the association of Krishna. Chintamani prakara sadamasu kalpa vriksa lakshah britesu sthiravira vipalayantam lakshmi sahasasata samrama sebhmanam govindam adipunisham tamaham bhajami. These are the descriptions of the Krishna law. Chintamani prakara sadamasu. The houses are made of such stone. Such stone. Parasi no, such stone. It's a small particle touch stone. If it is touched in the iron beam, it at once becomes gold. Of course, I do not know if anyone of you has seen this touch stone, but there is such a thing. So all the buildings are there of touch stone. Chintamani, prakara sadmasu, kalpa vriksha. The trees are desire tree. Whatever you like can get. Here, from mango tree you get mango, an apple tree from you get apple. But there, any tree, anything you like, you can have. These are some of the description of the Krishna law. Best thing is not to try for elevating ourselves in either of this material planet. Because in any material planet you enter, the same principles of miserable life. We are accustomed, we have been acclimatized to birth, death, we don't care. The modern scientists, they are very much proud of their advancement, but they have no solution of these unpleasant things. They cannot make anything which will check death, or which will check disease, or which will check old age. That is not possible. You can manufacture something which will accelerate death, but you cannot manufacture anything which will stop death. That is not in your power. So those who are intelligent enough, they are not concerned with these four things. Janma mrityu-jara-vyadhi, birth, death and old age. They are concerned to have spiritual life complete, full of bliss and full of knowledge. And that is possible when you enter into the spiritual plan. That will be explained. So next verse it is stated. Ananna cheta satatam jomam smarati nittasaha tasyam sulava prattha nittajittasya yogina. Nittajittasya yogina. Nittajitta means continuously in trance. It has joy, continuously thinking of Krishna, always engaged in Krishna consciousness. For him, Ananda Cheta, he does not divert his attention to this part of process or that part of yoga system or the jnana system or dhyana system, no. Ananda Cheta is simply the only one system, Krishna. Ananda Cheta, Ananda Cheta, without any deviation. It's not disturbed by anything. Simply Krishna. Ananna cheta satatam. Satatam means anywhere. And in any time. Just like my residence is at Vrindavan. That is the place of Krishna. When Krishna had rented himself, he was there. So, now I'm in America, in your country. But that does not mean that I'm out of Vrindavan. Because if I think of Krishna always, so it is as good I am in India and Vrindavan, I am as good as in New York in this apartment. The consciousness is there. So Krishna consciousness means you already live with Krishna in that spiritual planet. Simply you have to wait for giving up this body. So this is the process of Krishna consciousness. Ananna cheta satatam jumaṁ smarati. Smarati means remember. Nittasa, continually. The sāhaṁ sulava prātha. Oh, I am very cheap for them. Krishna becomes very cheap commodity. The highest valuable thing becomes very cheap for him who takes this process of Krishna consciousness. Sahaṁ sulavam prātha nitya diskatsa yogino. Because he is continually engaged in such process of yoga, bhakti yoga, I am very cheap. and easily available. And easily available. Now Krishna declares himself that he becomes easily available by this process. Why should I try for any, very hard job? Why should I take to that? We chant Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. 24 hours you can chant, there is no rules and regulations, either in the street, or in the subway, or at your home, or in your office, there is no tax, no expenses. Why don't you do it? Always chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. Thank you very much.